being independent, the Reminders are for real independent. They don't have a manager, they don't have nothing. They have love for each other, they have their children, they have God, and they have Colorado. That's who the Reminders are. And all of the people that really know, like if you ask Dave Chappelle and you ask Lauryn Hill and you ask Mos Def and you ask Nas and you ask Method Man and you ask like some of the greatest MCs of all time, they will tell you how much they love the Reminders, regardless of whether the industry is recognizing that or not. And so the thing that took somebody like me from being one of those people and made it so that I could tour around the world is because where I'm from is Minneapolis, Minnesota, and they support us and they show us a lot of love. And so the truth is that the Reminders are going all over the world. They're standing on stages in Africa and Europe and Asia and everywhere in between and the Middle East, and they're saying, yo, we're the Reminders, we're from Colorado Springs in this joint. And so every time that you see them do something, you have to support them. You have to support them. If they do a show, you gotta go. And you have the night of your life. If they post a video or something, you gotta share that joint. You know what I'm saying? That's the way that the thing builds up. Well, alright, I'm gonna do a new song if it's alright. This song is called Pray For Me. It's about me being a little kid and the way that they treat little kids when they're albino. It goes like this. Somebody please pray for me. Hey! Yes, Lord. And somebody pray for me. Somebody please pray for me. That's it. And make beautiful beats, son. Make beautiful music. Alright, true story, check it out. The first day of third grade, topic of discussion at the kickball game is who's the new student? Why does he look that way? An 8-year-old expert determined I had AIDS. Oh, what's the mistake and it became my name? I mean, literally, AIDS was my name, okay? It made its way around the school and eventually heard a teacher trying to catch herself and she yelled it to me. I tried to be invisible, honestly, wishing that the crown would just open up, swallow me. What kind of crime did I commit for this mockery? Guess I must have lost some kind of cosmic lottery. How am I processing this in a baby's age? It felt like I had a cut for the razor blades. I fantasized someone else to come take my place, cause they told me to hate my face. Somebody please pray for me.
Trying to catch up to you.